Hello students, let's start with the video with the chapter 1st of class 7th and the chapter name is Nutrition in Plants. So let's start the topic in detail. So before starting the topic nutrition, first we know about the nutrients. The component of food like carbohydrate, fat, protein, vitamins and minerals are called nutrients. Nutrients help living organism to build their body, to grow, to repair the damaged part of their bodies, to provide energy to carry out life processes. So all these are the nutrients that you see in the diagram: protein, water, fat, carbohydrate, undigestible food, minerals, vitamins. All these are the nutrients which are present in our food. So after getting the knowledge of nutrients, now come on the nutrition. The mode of taking food by an organism and its utilization in the body is called nutrition. Mode of nutritions. There are two main modes of nutrition in the living organism. And the two modes of nutrition is autotrophic nutrition and heterotrophic nutrition. So what is autotrophic nutrition? Is nutrition in which organism can prepare their own food. Auto means self, tropic means preparing. So organisms which can prepare their own food are called autotrophs. Now heterotrophic nutrition. In the heterotrophic nutrition, hetero word means different. Tropic means prepare. In nutrition in which organism get their food directly or indirectly from plants. And the organisms which get their food directly or indirectly from plants are called heterotrophs. So students, first we know about the process of photosynthesis. Photosynthesis is the process of food making process of plants. So photosynthesis is the process by which plant prepare their own food by using sunlight, water, carbon dioxide and chlorophyll. Photosynthesis takes place in the leaves. Sunlight is obtained from the sun. Water is absorbed by the root and transported to the leaves. Carbon dioxide is taken from the air through small pores in the leaves called stomata. Chlorophyll are the green pigment present in the leaves. As you see in the diagram that the stomata and the green color pigment present in the leaves. So chlorophyll uses the energy from sunlight to prepare food by using water and carbon dioxide. The food prepared is carbohydrate, which is then converted into starch. During photosynthesis, oxygen is released. So the photosynthesis process is right in a equation form when carbon dioxide and water is combined in presence of sunlight and chlorophyll, then carbon dioxide and water is converted into carbohydrate plus oxygen. So this is all about the photosynthesis. After the carbohydrate, some plants synthesize protein also. The soil has some bacteria which convert nitrogen from the air into usable nitrogen in the soil. Farmers also add fertilizers containing nitrogen into the soil. Plant absorb this nitrogen from the soil along with water and constituent to prepare proteins and fat. So students, here are some other modes of nutrition in plants are. So we will discuss. First is parasitic plants are the plants which do not have chlorophyll and cannot prepare their own food. They get their food from the other plants called host. Example is cuscuta or we can say amarbale. Next category of plant is insectivorous plant are the plants which feed on insect. Example is picture plant. The leaf of picture plant is modified into a picture
The end of the picture has a lid which can open and close. When insect enter the picture, the lid close. The insect is then digested by the digestive juices inside the picture. So as you see in the diagram, this is the diagram of picture plant and insect trap inside the picture.
So our next category of plant is saprotrophs, are the plants which do not have chlorophyll and cannot prepare their own food. They get their food from the dead and decaying organic matter. Example is mushroom, bread mold, etc. They produce digestive juices on the dead and decaying organic matter and convert it into a solution and then absorb the nutrient from the solution. So these all are the diagrams of saprotrophs. So our last category is symbiotic relationship. Some plants live together and share shelter and nutrient. Example is lichen. In lichen, an alga and a fungus live together. The fungus provide shelter, water and minerals to the alga, and the alga provide food to the fungus, which it prepared by photosynthesis. So this is all about the symbiotic relationship. So students, I hope you like the video regarding the nutrition in plants. Bye bye all, and have a nice day all of you.